Marketing analytics specialist Ebiquity has a new chief executive since January this year, and he's here by my side. His name is Michael Karg. Hello, Michael.
Thank you, Charlotte, for having me.
You're very welcome. Now, Michael, congratulations on the new position. Let's talk about your experience a little bit. Now, you've been a director of many international companies based in Asia, in the US and Europe. One is quite famous, it's Razorfish. So tell us a bit more about your experience, your professional journey, your experience in marketing.
Thank you for asking that. I have about 20 years of experience in marketing in a very international environment, most of it in digital, as you said, companies like Digitas or Razorfish. And I've been very much exposed from the very early beginning in marketing and marketing analytics. And I moved from there into running big international client engagements with US-based clients in particular, and later on moved on to Europe and built an international agency network from there.
And what's your proudest achievement?
Oh, that's a difficult question. I think one of the key things I'm very proud of is at the time when I worked at Digitas and we had only one office outside of the US and we started building an international agency network, we were starting at the very beginning to build offices from London to Asia and all over Europe. And I'm very proud of the achievement that we have achieved during the time period.
So why did you decide to join Ebiquity? Yeah. What do you like about the company?
Well, first of all, it's an amazing group of people. And I was really impressed by everybody I've met so far. I think it's a very deep subject matter expertise. It's focused on the craft of doing the work. I think the analytics space is very exciting. As I mentioned, I've started off in marketing analytics. I think it's a topic that's top of mind for CMOs, and I think Ebiquity is very well positioned and respected in the place.
So your appointment became effective in January this year. It's only been a few months so far. But what have you been focusing on?
Yeah, first of all, I try to understand, in particular, to meet the people in the business and understand what the core service offerings are and what we can bring for value to our clients. I've started to meet some clients and I've met some investors. And now I'm starting to create some themes of what I want to focus on and want to, you know, move the company forward.
So based on your experience and the team you have at Ebiquity, how will you grow the company going forward? What's your strategy?
Yeah, so far I've identified like six key areas to focus on growth. One of it is around global clients. We have an amazing set of clients already in our portfolio. We're working with 85 of the top 100 advertisers, and there's really significant amount of growth, both within our service offerings, but also across geographies. The second area of growth is bringing the network together. Ebiquity has been formed through acquisitions, and I think now is the time to work together as one Ebiquity globally. The third area is strengthening our fastest growing MPO business. I think we have a lot of organic growth that we are seeing there, and we are continuing to do that by expanding those capabilities in the US and also in Europe. And then obviously, as many of our investors and as you know, our MVM practice is our backbone of the business. It's growing very good as well, so we want to strengthen that and build on that leading position that we have in the marketplace. Lastly, the third service offering that we have is in our marketing intelligence practice. We are doing some product enhancements and refinements to, you know, make the product offering more competitive and stabilize our offering in that space. And that's sort of the focus areas that they have, together with selective, when they become available, acquisitions.
Okay, so acquisitions, what's the strategy for future acquisitions?
Yeah, first of all, I think we have two very strong growing parts of our business in the MPO side of the business and the MVM side of the business. And that's our core focus, growing those and, you know, growing organically. Of course, if there are acquisitions coming along that fit very well with our strategy and strengthen our positioning either from a geography perspective or from a product offerings perspective, we'll look into those.
And Michael, what's your assessment of the marketing analytics market? There's a lot going on, isn't there, with the shared economy and the digitization of the overall economy as well. What are the challenges and opportunities?
It's a fascinating time, you know, to be in business or in marketing at this point in time, because so many things are changing and new opportunities are coming along. And in particular with the use of data and data-driven decision-making, data-driven insight, it's on one hand liberating because there's so many more opportunities. On the other hand, also a little bit scary for many of our clients, how to handle the data, data ownership, data management, data privacy, driving relevance, and how will consumers react to that. I think it's a very exciting time from that perspective, and I think it opens up many, many opportunities for companies like ours.
So how well positioned is Ebiquity to benefit from all these opportunities?
Yeah, I think we are very well positioned in the marketplace. First of all, I think what's very important and increasingly important is the fact that we are independent and unbiased. it's very hard to find independent and unbiased advice in media and marketing in the industry per se, because most of the players in the marketplace have vested interests in one way or the other. Secondly, there are not many companies who are independent and providing analytics advice on a global basis. We have over 800 subject matter experts across 14 countries worldwide that are highly well respected and very well trained. So we can offer that service offering. And obviously, I think our track record in the media auditing and benchmarking space puts us in a very good position to have credibility with the clients to offer other services like, you know, analytics services.
Michael, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Michael Karg, the new Chief Executive Officer at marketing analytics specialist Ebiquity.